It is sunrise in Long Point, Ontario, a spectacular point of land jutting 40 kilometers into Lake Erie. It is known globally as a birder's paradise. In fact, everyone who is anyone in the bird world stops here mid-migration. Today, the Mercer Report goes to the birds. Actually, they will come to us. And this is Jody Allaire, and Jody is a bird biologist and a bird educator, all things bird. Hello, Jody, how are you?
Oh, Rick, nice to see you.
It is great to be here. Where are we exactly?
Yeah, we're at Long Point, Ontario, and we're at Long Point Bird Observatory.
This is a birder's paradise, correct?
What we do is study bird migration.
We are capturing birds.
So we're gonna catch birds to band them, but we're also
humanely
keeping track of all the birds that we see as well.
Songbirds.
Songbirds.
And then?
And then owls tonight.
Owls. That's pretty exciting.
It is pretty exciting.
What's your favorite bird?
What is my favorite bird?
Puffin, seagull.
Puffin and seagull? Puffins are amazing.
Puffins are awesome. And I only say seagull because no one ever says seagull.
Let's pick an owl. How about northern sawwood owl? You really can't.
That's what we're going to see tonight, right?
Absolutely. They're an incredible
bird. Maybe I'll
bird.
Get a new favorite bird. Maybe the seagull will be bumped off the list. Sorry, gull, you're dead to me. And this is Stuart Mackenzie. He is a program director here at the Long Point Bird Observatory. Hello, Stuart, how are you?
Hi, Rick, nice to meet you.
Good to see you, sir. So this morning, it's about the songbirds, correct?
Correct. Well, we have specialized nets that kind of look like volleyball nets.
And then do you call the birds?
We can.
Can you do
they
that?
Just go in passively, but you can try and
can
lure them
in. Can you
show
me some of that?
Well, the classic birder trick is the pish. Do you want to learn how to pish?
I would like to see you pish.
So the classic pish is the psh, 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 psh. You see birders doing that all the time.
Psh, 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 psh.
Yeah, exactly.
And so a bird will fly in and then maybe go down? Is that the idea?
Yep, they just fall right into the bag.
Here we go. Oh, look at that!
And you just extract them very similar to how they went in. This is a white-throated sparrow.
Now, why are we putting a bird in a bag?
In the bag, it's a nice, dark, soft place.
Okay, let's go in there.
Where they can, where they'll just relax. Any good day is over 100, but we can do as many as 400 or 500 in a day.
How many volunteers do you have working to process 400 or 500 birds?
We'd have a team, probably around 6 individuals of people that are expertly trained to extract the birds and handle them and band them very quickly.
That's incredibly efficient.
It's a well-oiled machine. So this is a golden-crowned kinglet.
Look at that. It's like a Christmas ornament. Oh, look at the orange in there.
Orange in their crest. All the males have orange. Females just have yellow.
So the nets are up. The sawwet calls are playing. What do we do now?
Now we wait.
Now we wait.
What heron can be identified by its black beak and legs?
Pass.
Are a tern's feet webbed, half-webbed, lobed, or divorced?
Pass.
Where does the great egret lay its eggs?
At home.
I need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle.
I'm looking for John Carter.
Rick, let's go check the nets.
Okay, here we are. What's going on?
Well, we're gonna go check the nets. Mm-hmm. We got a red headlamp, so it's a little bit easier on the owl's eyes, and we're gonna go take them out of the net.
I brought that from home. I'll leave it here. Let's go.
Okay, follow me. And there she is.
She's beautiful.
Yeah, they really are amazing. And it's pretty cool to think it's been migrating at night already, and who knows how far this bird's come.
This is very cool. He's very calm.
Yeah, they are very calm. Yeah, they're an incredible little migrant. Quite mysterious, and we're still learning a lot about them with our banding work here. At Long Point Bird Observatory.
Let's go learn some more.
Yeah, let's take it to the banding lab.
Yes, to the banding lab. How can bird watching not be a TV show? I feel like we've been fishing. Look! This is the northern sawwet owl.
Yeah.
They are so soft. It's ridiculous how soft this owl is. That's the softest owl I've ever felt.
So the next thing we're gonna do is get a weight and we're gonna-
How do you weigh an owl?
Okay, well, I'll show you. So what we're gonna do is use the scale. Okay, so we're gonna subtract the weight of the tube on the scale.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and then we're gonna put the owl upside down into the tube so we can get a weight on it.
Head first.
Head first. Okay, make sure the wings are tucked in.
She's tucked. She's tucked.
You're a natural, Mercer. No, that's probably good right there.
105. Okay.
The ninja strikes.
Look, the ninja struck.
There you go. So these ones are its juvenile feathers. It's feathers from its first year. And these are feathers that it just grew this year. So it's actually a bird in its second year.
Okay. So that's how you know its age.
That's how we know its age.
Now, you want to measure its wing, correct?
We actually put a band on it first.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you want me to put the band on?
Do you want to do the band?
Yes.
Okay.
This is a friendship band. All the birds are going to want one of these. Is it done?
Yeah, let go.
Okay. Come back next week, I'll do your belly button.
140.
140 it is.
Okay.
You're doing right. Great. I won't put you in my pocket and take you home because that would be bad, right?
That's bad.
No, yeah. Because this bird belongs in the wild. Here we go. Time to go home.
There you go.
Oh, you're gonna hang out for a bit. Well, that's good.
Yeah, sometimes they need their eyes to adjust.
I think it's time for you to go. You have to continue your migration. Follow the Canadian geese. Go. Be one with nature. You can't stay here. You can leave my hand. Oh, you're pooing all over me. That's okay, we're friends. That was a hoot, other than this part.